The universe is so vast that it's impossible to know about all of it. It's full of beautiful and scary places and never ceases to amaze us. But in this arguably infinite space, Earth has been the only planet that has life, at least as far as we know it. Among those billions of other planets, why haven't we found life anywhere else? Sir Arthur Clarke once said, "We are either alone in this universe or we are not, and both are equally scary." Can it be that we are alone in this universe? Or if we aren't, where are the aliens? Our universe is so vast, but still, we have found no trace of life on another planet, even traces of microbial life. We have a lot of galaxies very similar to the Milky Way, and they might have a solar system like ours. And some of these stars might have planets similar to Earth, and even have water, just like Kepler-432b. Some places might have intelligent life, because the universe is very old and many stars and planets have been formed before the human beings came into existence. If any civilization existed in this old universe, they might have had a lot of time to advance themselves. 13.6 billion years is how old our Milky Way is. Initially, it was not suitable for habitation, but after 2 to 3 billion years, the conditions were hospitable for civilizations to exist. Since our planet is about 4.5 billion years old, many civilizations could have existed before us. Based on the Kardashev scale, civilizations are of three types. A type 1 civilization is the one that has used all the resources of its planet. We are currently 0.75 on this scale. A type 2 civilization is the one that has used all the energy of its host star, like the concept of Dyson sphere. A type 3 civilization is the one that has colonized and used all the natural resources of its galaxy. So if that's the case and living out all the possibilities that we are not alone, where are all the aliens? Why haven't we met or seen any traces of them? Where is everybody? Welcome to the Fermi Paradox. No one has answers to this and all we have are theories. But in this video, we're going to discuss some of these possible answers to the Fermi Paradox. Reason number one, we haven't observed it. Search for Extraterrestrial Life, or SETI, is an organization dedicated to finding evidence of life in other places of our universe. But SETI has always been underfunded and looked down upon by the world. In the beginning, SETI was well established like NASA, until Congress cut down its funding and now it mainly relies on donations. In the Milky Way, SETI has only observed about a fraction of the entire galaxy. The analogy is like going to a beach and taking some water in a beaker and saying that there are no sharks in the ocean because there isn't one in the beaker. We've sampled only a minuscule amount of the universe. We all know life has occurred in extreme and harsh environments, which is evident from life on Earth. The universe is vast enough with trillions and trillions of planets, so it can be possible that life could occur anywhere. It's just that we haven't observed it. Reason number two, the zoo hypothesis. Another idea is that there is a very advanced type 3 civilization out there that monitors the galaxy. Once any civilization reaches a certain level of intelligence, this type 3 then destroys it. It is possible that they might have passed all kinds of hindrances for life to exist, and now at a very advanced state of intelligence. To prevent the competition in the future, when we start to advance into a higher civilization, they might contact us and kill us. We could be just like the viruses that start and spread. We know this as the zoo hypothesis. We might be in a tightly regulated galaxy, and they treat our planet like part of a vast and protected national park. We cannot notice them as they are far greater than us and have a rule for when to communicate with us. That seems really scary. Reason number three, there are galactic predators. Another idea is that there might be scary predator civilization out there, and they are smart enough to not broadcast their location and remain discreet. This would mean that we are fools, in fact, and cannot see them because they don't want us to. This also explains why we haven't found signals in SETI. Because as Stephen Hawking said, if they visit us, the outcome would be the same as when Columbus landed in America, which didn't turn out well for the Native Americans. Perhaps it's certainly not going to be a friendly meetup. there are other reasons why advanced aliens may keep their heads down. Self-preservation comes to mind. What if they're trying to avoid being destroyed or being enslaved? Well, this seems legit because it's the nature of beings that we're trying to protect our kind. Like a squirrel will protect a squirrel, and parents will protect their kids because they want generations to pass on. That's why they are discreet. But if they come in contact with us, their civilization might destroy us, seeing us as a threat. Reason number four, we are alone. I know that this isn't the most anticipated answer you'll ever want to hear, but one last idea is that we might be completely alone in this entire universe. This thought is scary. What if we are all that matters? What's so special about us that we are the only life in the universe? Are we the only ones looking out in hope to find another life? Do we have to share this with anyone else? And if that's the case, we would have to become the first Type 3 civilization in this universe and advance to the next level. Though humans have always considered themselves as special, this idea is disturbing. We may be completely alone in this infinite, empty void of space. So what do you think about the Fermi paradox? Are we alone, or is there someone out there waiting for us? Let us know your answer in the comment section below, and don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel and press the bell notification to be notified for more curiosity videos like this. Thanks.